All right, well, welcome back, Vikings fans. And with that, Gabe and I bring in our special guest. It's Vikings senior defensive assistant, Paul Guenther. And I'm super excited that you're joining the staff because I know you go back pretty far with the Zimmer family. So I just have to start off the show saying, give us a story of your time in Cincinnati with Coach Zimmer and Adam Zimmer.
There's a lot of stories to be told. I mean, we've been through a lot of stuff together, whether it be off the field, on the field. I think we did a series of Hard Knocks together one or two times, actually. So there's been a lot of stories. It was a pleasure to work with them back then, both guys, and I'm excited to be back here working with him in Minnesota.
Coach, 13 years in Cincinnati. Of course, you spent 2 years before that in Washington, but last 3 years you were in Las Vegas and now you're with the Minnesota Vikings. What brought you to this point right now to the Vikings?
I just think, when Coach gave me a call and said he was interested in having me come out here, it was something that I felt good about. I feel good about how he runs his program. I know the values that he has, how he runs the team, how he treats the players, how he treats the coaching staff. I was really familiar with that and I was comfortable with that. And I was really excited because I think they have a good team here. They have a chance to, they had a lot of young guys play last year and they had really good success on offense and some young guys playing on defense. We got some guys back here where they can make a splash here this coming year.
So you spent six seasons with Coach Zimmer and obviously the whole family there in Cincinnati. At the time, did you know that Mike was going to become a head coach in this league?
Without a doubt. I mean, you could just see the respect that the players have for him, his knowledge of the game, his motivational tactics, just everything. You could see that even as a defensive coordinator in Cincinnati, that it wasn't going to be long if we had success there, that someone was going to knock on his door and ask him to be the head coach. So it probably took a little bit longer than it should for him, in my opinion, but he's an excellent head coach nonetheless.
What about Adam, though? Adam Zimmer, I think when you first met him, he was early 20s. Now he's, transitioning to a co-defensive coordinator. Mm-hmm. How have you, just talk about seeing him grow into the role he is in now.
Yeah, I mean, he had been coaching some different spots. I think it was Kansas City and New Orleans when Mike and I were in Cincinnati together. And he had an opportunity for the 1 year before Mike came here to be on the staff. So I got to work closely with Adam. He's very knowledgeable of the system. Throughout the time when they came to Minnesota and I stayed in Cincinnati and then went to Vegas, you could see the knowledge base grow with Adam just sitting here in a meeting room with him and going through some of the adjustments and scheme adjustments that we're talking about here in the offseason. So he's grown tremendously as a coach and I'm glad to be working with him.
Nick Vigil, you guys added him to the roster, a linebacker who you probably took part in drafting as a third round pick a few years ago in Cincinnati. So what does Nick kind of bring to this Vikings defense and why did you want to bring him here to Minnesota?
I just think Nick's a guy, we obviously drafted him in Cincinnati. He started early on in his career there. He can play all three of the linebacker positions. He's very smart. He wore the green dot for us at times in Cincinnati. So it's a guy that can communicate really good. He understands what we're doing. So it's obviously, with the lack of an off season or, the shortness of an off season, he's going to know what we're doing pretty quick. So he's a guy that kind of got mixed up a little bit, maybe with a coaching change in Cincinnati, went to San Diego for a year for LA with the Chargers for a year and he became free. And he's a guy that I always liked. You can rely on him. He's a very good player. He's versatile, he can play on special teams. So it's a valuable guy to have in the program.
Coach, from being, hands-on, right? I mean, your last season at Yersinious College, you were a head coach there, and then you were assistant coach in Washington, and you worked your way up in the NFL ranks to becoming the defensive coordinator last year for the Las Vegas Raiders. Like, now that you're the senior defensive assistant, what about the mental process changes now for you?
Nothing really. I told Mike to come here and help him win. I mean, whether it's working with any levels of the defense, a scheme, a situational thing, a clock management thing, whatever it may be that I can help out the team win, that's what I'm here to do. So obviously calling on the defense for the last 8 years as a coordinator, you have a real good feel for, you know, maybe some of the things that are problem areas or quick fixes that you need to fix on Sundays, or maybe during the week, something comes up that, hey, I've been through this before. It's an easy fix. Let's look at it this way. And it's a different set of eyes and ears and those type of things around the players. So that to me is what I'm here to do, whatever Mike asked me to do, and to help this team win.
Could you talk about just the your mental process as far as like changing teams? Like, we hear players talk about changing teams, and I mean, I saw a clip the other night, Blake Griffin accidentally cheered for the Detroit Pistons when the other team dunked. So like, for you, like watching a new team on film, like what does that process look like to say like, okay, like I'm watching the Vikings, not the Raiders?
Right. It is different at first. I mean, you're really just trying to get familiarized with the players on the team. You know, we do watch a lot of the Vikings defense the last years when I was in Cincinnati and in Oakland, because our schemes are so similar. So you're familiar with those guys and what they're doing. So, you know, our players can watch and say, yeah, I know where he's supposed to be, where this guy's supposed to be. So I was familiar with their personnel, but just some of the younger guys that I wasn't quite as familiar with, that's been fun to sit and watch the cutups of those guys, whether it be the corners or the linebackers, or even some of the D-line guys, the young guys that have been playing a lot here as a rookies and first year players. So it's been fun that way to get a knowledge base of their abilities and their skill levels, what they can do good and what positions we can put them in to succeed.
One thing that stands out to me is just listening to Coach Zimmer in his press conferences. He'll bring up talking to Bill Parcells and getting some advice, and the reporters always ask, like, what is it that you guys talked about? I think it was last year or the year before where he said, I gave Coach Paul Guenther a call over at the Las Vegas Raiders and had some chats about whether it was advice or just friendly, whatever it was. What does that mean to you to be in Coach Zimmer's circle and now he brings you in on his staff?
Well, I just, you know, obviously it's good to be close. I mean, he's taught me a lot of football as being an assistant with him in Cincinnati. I owe him a lot of credit for that. So, you know, just working aside with him in the defensive room, helping him out with whatever, maybe it could be some of the team thing, whatever it is. I kind of understand what he's thinking about and what he's trying to get to as far as the next step of things. So we've always shared ideas, whether it be during the season. We get together a lot during the summer. He goes down to a ranch in Kentucky. I'll go down there for a few days and we'll get the grease board out and film and go through it and dissect it and compare and contrast ideas. And it's always a good thing to have a guy to bounce off. It's not a better guy than him to bounce off some different ideas.
What's it like hearing the play call when he's calling it on game day and you got to either get one of the players ready or you hear something getting yelled at you through? What is that experience like? Everyone wants to know what that's like.
You know, if he's doing the right thing, Mike's going to, you know, pat him on and say, hey, you're doing the right thing. That's what you're supposed to be doing. But if you're not used, you know, this is a technique-based defense, an effort-based defense, and there's some things that are non-negotiable. So you have to be able to play the techniques the right way. And when the techniques aren't played the right way, that's when Mike goes off sideways a little bit. So, you know, as a position coach, you know, I may have to call down to the players, say, hey, calm down, go to the next play. You're only as good as your next good play. Don't worry about the last bad one. So that's what Mike's always been good at, whether he's been a coordinator, as a head coach. He's been able to hold the players accountable, which I think is very important to be successful in the NFL.
I think another important reason for success for you is, I guess, finding a new home and getting accustomed to Minnesota. So how has that process been for you?
That's been great. I think it's a beautiful place to live. Obviously, coming from Las Vegas, I came in about a month ago when I think it was like minus 15 or something. And it took the breath away from me when I came out of the airport. But, you know, the weather's turned nice here. And it's a very nice area, good place to live, beautiful place. And the facility we have here is second to none. The organization second to none, and I know they're all in on winning. So, and doing it the right way along the way. So again, I'm excited to be here. Can't wait to get started with OTAs, training camp, and then the season.
Last question for me. You obviously have been to US Bank Stadium. You've seen a game with fans there.
Nightmare. I mean,
what is it going to be like to have fans back in the building and to be on the side of the purple?
I will say this. This is a tough place to play. It is loud. It's ornery coming here from another team. You know, those horns blow, the Viking horn blows. You know, you leave the stadium, you're like, you hear that horn for the next 3 days after the game. So it's definitely a home field advantage. We're Hopefully we can fill the stadium up by the time the season starts and we can get our fans back in. I'm sure the fans are excited to come back and watch live football and be a part of a winning season here with the Vikings.
Yeah, looking forward to it, Coach. Looking forward to winning season. Looking forward to your contributions to this defense. In the meantime, stay safe.
Appreciate it, guys.